In my previous video, I've introduced SAID, the stream editor. Among SAID's various commands, the substitution command is probably the one you will find the most useful, as it can do very clever text transformations. And we will see that right now, on 6 different examples of increasing complexity. Okay, are you ready? For our very first example, we will use the most basic substitution pattern. Here, we will simply replace a word by another one. Or, more strictly speaking, we will replace a string of characters by another string of characters. But even that simple substitution has its share of subtleties. Did you see what I'm talking about? If you look closely, you will notice only the first occurrence of the word lead on each line was replaced. If you want to remove each occurrence of lead by gold, you will need to add the global flag. Even with that, this is still not perfect as the word leader has been replaced too. To avoid that, we may explicitly search for word boundaries before and after the string lead. That way, only the word lead has been replaced. But you're right. Such replace features are available in any text editor. So let's try something a little bit more exciting. To leverage the full power of the substitution command, you have to know the search pattern is a regular expression. That means some characters have a special meaning to help you describe the search string in a more abstract manner. We've seen that just before when using the word boundary mark, but there are lots of other meta characters available to you. For example, the dot means any character. So if I want to censor text by replacing every character by a star, I can write that. Okay, this is not particularly useful. So let's refine that a little bit by replacing this time only characters in the A to Z range by a star. Oh, I missed the capital letters. It's easy to fix that using the any letter meta character. Finally, for another example, I might want to replace only words between backticks by stars, and indeed, this is quite useful when preparing tests for my students. To fully understand that example, you must know the star has a special meaning in the search string, where it means 0 or more occurrences of the previous pattern. But the star is an ordinary character in the replacement string. However, if the star is an ordinary character in the replacement string, some other characters have a special meaning there too. Notably, the ampersand is used to mean the matching text. This is especially useful when you need to alter text around some search pattern. Here I have an HTML fragment and I want to add emphasis around some words. Copying the full matching string is nice, but sometimes we don't need the entire text, but only the content of one or several sub-patterns. For that purpose, a parenthesis in the search string defines what is called a capturing group. That group can be referenced by its index in the replacement string. And I realize this is hardly understandable. So here is an example. The text before the comma in my input file will be capturing group 1. The text after the comma will be capturing group 2. And the replacement string will be made of the text of group 2 followed by the text of group 1, in that order. So basically, this will swap the two columns of my data file. We already used the G flag at the end of the substitution pattern to perform a global replacement. But there are other flags available. For example, the W flag, to append a line to some external file, but only when a substitution was performed. To understand the power of that flag, let's examine some file containing a list of URLs. In that file, some URLs are HTTP, some others are HTTPS. My goal is to split HTTP and HTTPS URLs in two different files. The nice thing with the write flag is you are able to split some input file into several output files in only one pass. When working with large files, this can really speed up data processing. At this point, you know that capturing groups can be referenced in the replacement string. But they can be referenced too in the search string. I let you few seconds to guess what will do this expression. Alright, you've got it? This pattern aims at removing duplicate words appearing on the same line. But apparently it is not perfect. Maybe you will be able to fix that now. So don't hesitate to use the comment section below to suggest your own solution. I'm really looking forward to reading you.